The protests set off by the killing of George Floyd in Minneapolis, Minnesota, are being led by a new generation of young activists, many who also want to bring more attention to the stories of police violence against black women. I spoke recently with Keisha Blain, an associate professor of history at the University of Pittsburgh and author of Set the World on Fire, Black Nationalist Women and the Global Struggle for Freedom. Dr. Blain, it seems as we have this national conversation that's been prompted in part by George Floyd's death, that there is something else that we're missing when it comes to an entire gender that's struggling with the same things.
Yes, I think so. In fact, many activists in the last few weeks have been pointing out the fact that even before the police killing of George Floyd, Breonna Taylor was killed by the police, an EMT worker in Louisville, Kentucky. And activists have been insisting that we really pay attention to this case. To this very day, the police officers who killed Taylor have not been arrested. And I think more and more people are certainly talking about Breonna Taylor, but that was just one example of how Black women's experiences are often sidelined in national narratives about American policing.
There was a whole Say Her Name campaign that was quite successful in trying to raise awareness of it, but it wasn't something that, and it still isn't something that creates the same kind of headlines. Why do you think that is?
Well, certainly I think the data reveals to us that the majority of Black people who are killed by police are young Black men. So in some ways, the focus on Black men is very much reflective of what the data tells us. But the truth is that there's also, I think, to a large extent, perhaps we might say sexism and even patriarchy, which is to say that the way people write about American policing tends to focus primarily on the experiences of Black men. And even as we recognize that most Black men are killed by the police, I think the key here is to tell the whole story. The key here is to make it clear that Black women and girls are also vulnerable to state-sanctioned violence.
What about the impact of the violence on everybody that's related to or connected to the individual, right? Whether they're mothers or sisters or daughters, that there is trauma that it's not just the one person that died that got hurt, so to speak.
Exactly. And we see that clearly with the recent case of Eric Garner. Within days of Garner's death, we saw his daughter, Erica, rising just on a national scene, pushing the issue, demanding changes in American policing. But the key here is that Black women are certainly affected. We can talk about trauma, we can talk about just the emotional turmoil that they go through. And it's not surprising then that they are often the ones at the forefront of the fight to bring an end to police violence and brutality.
And you literally have written the book on this, that being at the forefront of the fight is something the Black women have been doing for quite some time.
Absolutely. And my book, Set the World on Fire, focuses primarily on working class Black women and impoverished Black women. And I think that's key too, because many of the women who I talk about did not have much of a formal education. Many of them did not have much material resources. But what they did have was passion, and what they did have were their voices, and what they did have was the ability to just open up and explain what the problems were in their community, take to the streets and demand changes. And even when they didn't have access to the vote, at a time where Black women could not vote in the early 20th century, these women were still determined to make changes, to shape national politics and also global politics.
Keisha Blain, Associate Professor, University of Pittsburgh. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.